Out of hats, out of drawers. Do you like the set? This marvellous old ruined Belgian garage here. I'm going to be pulling on such people as Jerry Dammers, Thomas Dolby. I think there's a Barry Andrews in there somewhere, piece of the set falling down there. But first of all, I'd like to show you a XTC film from a long time ago. It's a film called Wonderland. Take it away.
Hello, Mr. Partridge, sir.
Well, hello.
Welcome to the sci-fi music.
I'm talking to a robot, I can't believe this. It's like having a meaningful conversation with a blender. Your name is Spencer, is it?
That's right, sir. I'm the caretaker of this sci-fi music,
this,
though, sir.
This is your head, is it?
Yes, that's it, sir.
Is this the same head that Mr. Steve Strange snapped off in a bit of friends?
Oh, Mr. Strange, sir.
Mr. Strange.
Yes, one of my friends, sir.
Yes, right. Well, shall I take you by the
hand,
and where would you like to lead me around this fine complex?
Well, let's go over here first.
Let's go over here, right.
This is our desk.
This is the desk?
Yes, you can have a seat there whenever you want to, sir.
You have the grooviest, latest modern technology here.
If you want the coffee machine, it's up there, sir.
The coffee machine is where?
Just to your right.
To my right.
Up there, sir.
Oh, this is the coffee machine,
sir. No, up there.
This is the acid machine. This is a coffee machine. Oh, right.
Coffee percolator.
Very old steam organ, this one.
If you want your hair dried, sir, it's over there.
I can't believe it.
Would you find a good lab up here, sir?
It's very wonderful. Well, how did you get the name Spencer, Spencer?
Well, they just gave me it, sir. Seems like any good name as good as any other, really, sir.
Son of Marx, I can see. Right, well, they're going to ask me to introduce something else here, and on my little upside-down list, it says, Big Country, Wonderland, the bitches. Well, there's the marvellously coincidentally titled Wonderland from Big Country, or the Bigs, as their friend know them. I've got Mr. Special himself here, Jerry Dammers. Hello, Jerry.
Hello, hello.
You're aiding me in this wonderfully musical farce that we're involved in here.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it?
I came up on the train this morning and I wrote the most biggest load of dribble to ask you. I mean, you don't deserve these questions I'm going to spring on you. But question number one in my grubby 10-pence notebook is, you've got the mic technique here, this is very good. Study Jerry's mic technique here, or you budding nightclub musicians.
Is it close enough? Can you hear me?
Right. Question number one. How on earth did you arrive at this Egyptian horror music style of organ playing? It's peppered throughout your work, this kind of strange quasi-Egyptian.
Yeah, I don't know, really. I'll blame it all on John Shipley, I think, our guitarist, because he's very much into...
Egyptian.
No, but he's very much into sort of music, or he was. And film soundtracks, things like that. And but also, I went on holiday to Cairo.
Aha!
Aha!
Now the truth can be told.
And I heard a lot of that kind of music. I do like that sort of music a lot.
Those sort of scales coming into a lot.
I love tuning in on the radio, and you just hear it sort of vaguely somewhere in the background, sort of wailing away.
Yeah, I've got all sorts of things here. The your album in the studio. It's got quite a history, hasn't it? Quite a long...
Yeah, too long a history, yeah.
You think it's too long? Did you not intend it to take that long?
No, it was... I think the curse of the mummy was on the album or something. Every conceivable thing that had gone wrong went wrong.
Yeah.
So, that could go wrong. I think there's... It's just the kind of chemistry in the group. The original Specials had... Everyone had their role to play, and it was kind of... The chemistry between the people works, but with this band it's been a lot more difficult.
Mm, well, you have to work harder at keeping them together. But I mean, the results are very impressive. They're as impressive, if not more so, than the original Specials.
Yeah, I was pleased with it in the end, but I think there's a lot to be said for doing things quickly, not only from the musical point of view, but, you know, certainly the financial point of view, because we're in real mess now because it costs so much. You know.
Okay, well, I think we're going to have a look now on my special grubby piece of pink sci-fi music show paper. It says we're going to see the video, which is... Here, would you like to read out this stunning title here?
What I like most about... Oh, it doesn't say... No, it says, what I like most is your girlfriend.
Well, that'll do.
That is your girlfriend.
This one, yeah. Jerry'd like to introduce his girlfriend. This is the one that
This is the one.
Hello.
This is the one that everyone likes the most. Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir.
Look at this. I mean, you want coffee? You want coffee or tea, Jerry?
Oh, that's very unpleasant, sir. Didn't enjoy that at all. Never mind, Mr. Pleasant. You carry on interviewing that, Mr. Jerry.
How does one kick this in the nuts? I mean,
no nuts, sir. All sealed.
All bolts.
Girl, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes.
Kick him in the bolts.
Thank you.
Well, Jerry, was that you
Granted.
Or him?
You're he's getting rather close to you, isn't he?
He is. He's getting,
sorry, yes,
you're getting alarmingly intimate, Spencer. Do you want to?
Well, I'll move back off.
Back off! Back off!
Right then.
Yeah, question time again. You're very much an organ man. You take this how you want. You're very much an organ man.
I don't think I've ever seen you with a synth.
I haven't got one yet. But I'm going to buy one, I think.
Ah,
see what
so
like.
You're coming in.
Yeah.
You're coming in out of the closet.
That's right.
To What is it about organs? Is it just you sort of have a liking for that Hammond?
It's a Yamaha, actually.
It's a Yamaha?
Yeah. I don't know. I like this sort of...
the Jimmy Smith
sort of sound of the Yamaha. You know, it's like a horrible nightclub or something. You know? It's got that atmosphere about it.
The sleeve to your album, the In The Studio album, it looks very...
morbid.
No, it's just very reminiscent of, did I say that? It's very reminiscent of kind of a 50s sleeve.
Yeah, well, we ripped it off Bud Powell LP, I think it is. Blues in the Closet. It's very similar to that, but, yes.
Who came up with the idea? Because I've studied the sleeve and everything looks kind of well in place, you know, the old microphones and amplifiers
yeah.
and stuff.
Well, it was just that... the band had been in the studio for so long and it was obvious that, you know, we were splitting up before we even got out of the studio, you know what I mean? Because the singer's now left, Stan, the lead singer that was.
Mm.
That's why I'm singing on this thing.
Mm.
But it was just, I don't know, it just seemed like a good idea for the cover.
No, it's a great one. It's just excitingly mundane is a way of, I mean, you can be mundane and be exciting in my books. The video for The Girlfriend, who was the chap behind that?
It was Jeff Baines, but I sort of worked out the story and the cast and the locations and everything.
I thought I was going crazy, actually. I've seen a black and white version.
There's
a colour version.
I actually enjoy doing the videos more than the music now. I like to get into directing videos.
A ham actor of the finest degree. Right, well, we're going to have a look at a track now, which is Free Nelson Mandela. Here we go. Thomas, me bonnie wee laddie. That's a hell of a video, that.
Oh,
I must admit, I'm very keen on that. One of the years, in fact, the century's better videos.
Yeah, thank you.
It looks like it took a lot of sorting out all those little bits and pieces.
Yeah, it did. Fortunately, a lot of it was actually happening there in the studio, in other words, because we shot it on tape. I could actually see on a monitor, I could see all the stuff that was
so it's kind of
effects that were going on.
A lot of off the cuff as it went along.
We prepared a lot of the electronic effects in advance. And then on the day we just sort of improvised, we just shot the thing about a dozen different ways and chopped it together afterwards.
Now, how true is this? I've been told this, but I must admit I didn't believe it. How true is it about your father being an archaeologist?
Well, it's true. He's the world authority on Greek and Etruscan pottery.
You're joking?
I'm not joking.
No,
that's what
I said to somebody else. That's a hell of a trade to be in. I mean, everybody's old man is usually either a bus driver or works in a laundry somewhere.
Yeah.
Mm. Were you not tempted to follow him into the archaeology trade, as it were?
Well, it never used to interest me that much, actually. I thought it was just sort of a bunch of dirty pots, really. You know? I suppose as I grew a bit older, I started to realise that, in fact, they had a lot in common. You know, what he was really interested in was the people and the places. And there's a sort of thin line between history and mythology, and that's what it's all about, really. And in fact, those are a lot of the same things that kind of motivate me, but I've just chosen a different vehicle for it.
You've had a lot of this... nutty professor image thrown at you.
Yeah.
I mean, do you...
Mainly,
do you allow it...
Firstly, by you, actually.
No, it wasn't me, Fox, it wasn't me. I mean, do you allow... How much of it do you allow to stick? I mean, do you use what comes your way, or do you spend a lot of time judging it?
No, I think inevitably you tend to, you know, you become the way that people view you. I mean, I suppose when I made a record called She Blinded Me With Science, and the video to go with that, then it was interpreted as being very much a sort of, you know...
Yeah, it sets the pattern.
Right.
OK, well, we're going to have a look at another video now. It's quite a loungy piece, this.
Yeah.
Is this an area that you're going to follow in future, the kind of
I think
one
just,
man alone with his keyboard?
Well, I think I wouldn't like to be pigeonholed as just the one particular thing, so I decided to do a slightly more gentle song and the video to go with it.
Right, let's have a look at I Scare Myself. Tom Dolby, the man himself, scaring himself, totally sure of it. Right, well, you have to go. You have to yell bye-bye into my shirt now, Tom.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, did we get that? You getting that in the Shetlands? Right, so, bye-bye to Tom Dolby. And he does a quick change and comes back horribly mutated. John Revolta.
Goodbye, Tom. Hello, Andy.
Oh, and here's the radioactive fallout version. Come and sit by Uranus, Barry. Here we go. Now, you haven't brought a little film with you, have you, that we
no,
can show?
No, we don't
so
have a little film.
You're just going to have to dance live.
I know.
Gyrate live. Well, this is quite make a historic... I must point out, this is quite a historic meeting, this. I think the last time that I saw Barry in the flesh, as it were, was, what,
1979?
Way back in the halcyon days of spiky hair when I had some. I've got also... I mean, God, I've written War and Peace here, do I ask you? So... Can you fill us in? The years after XTC and...
We should perhaps point out that Andy and I used to be in a band.
The same band, B-A-N-N-E-D, together. when you left XTC, I mean, it must be like sort of finishing the First World War, wondering what to do. What did you do pre-Shriekback? Because Barry is now a Shriekback. What did you do pre-to Shriekback?
Well, after I left XTC, I came to London and had... Actually, we haven't had this conversation.
We have. This is weird. Weird one, folks.
I was in London for a long time, and I did an album with Iggy Pop the year I left. And after that, I did some work with Robert Fripp. I was in a band with Fripp.
That's right, League of Gentlemen.
League of Gentlemen. I did that for a year.
I'm just wondering, I thought that was your sort of steady pigeon, League of Gentlemen. I thought, well, he's found it now.
No, it wasn't.
So,
really.
What happened? I mean...
That was a bit like, I don't know, going to night school, I think.
Yeah, Robert Fripp was head of the class.
Advanced Gurdjieffian metaphysics.
I can't follow that. What, then you had a brief flirtation with a marvellously named restaurant for dogs.
Yeah, I thought I'd better try putting my own group together, since I'd never done it before, and I was a sideman, really, somebody else's sideman for quite a long time. And I think a lot of what went wrong with the first XTC was really that I didn't want to be a sideman.
That's quite right. That's quite right. So you were fewer for with Restaurant for Dogs for a while.
Yeah, yeah. And
now you're a shrinker.
Really just putting the whole logistical thing of that together was very difficult.
Mm.
And when I ran into Dave Allen, who was the bass player in Gang of Four, who's very good at bands and phone calls and studio time. And
organizer.
All that.
Organizer.
I was quite glad to go like that.
There's somebody making horrible windmill signs at us. So, strangely enough, we're going to be having a look at a video by Yellow. I can't believe this, but here he goes. He's lost a game by Yellow. Yes, we're back here with real deep talk with Mr. Barry Andrews, a Shriekback by any other name. I feel like I'm doing the news here. Do you want to read the latest mining situation? Your keyboard style is ludicrously idiosyncratic.
Thank you very much.
You sound like nobody else on this or indeed this planet. So if you can encapsulate it in one or two flippant sentences, how the hell did you arrive at playing like you do?
I don't know. I suppose I never really learned piano, so it's kind of
professional.
Instead of working your way through the way you're taught to play something, you sort of make it up as you go along, and when you discover all the electronic instruments, like from, you know, my little knackered Krumah Group 49 organ up to the Fairlight,
that's a hell of an organ. You've had that for quite some time now.
Well,
I mean, I didn't think it was going to get through the early gigs that we did, and here it is, it's still alive in
some
form.
It's still around. It was on telly a little while ago.
I didn't see it. I didn't see it. Mind you, I don't watch Animal Magic much these days. But,
Guy's own chat show now.
I can't follow that. Do you remember the self-indulgent parakeet ensemble with Rinaldo?
Might do.
Do you want to tell people if I've got the right change of me?
We played the Arts Centre in Swindon.
As the self-indulgent?
As the self-indulgent parakeets with Rinaldo.
But who was Rinaldo and what was his role in the gig?
I can't remember, actually. Remind me. Jeff Fitch's coming on and eating a Chinese meal for the entire length of the set.
That's right. Well, in fact, the visuals for the gig were the three of us, myself, Barry and Terry Chambers, who pressed a drum box on and off, sat in the dark, and the roadie Jeff ate a meal at the front of the stage under the name of Rinaldo.
There's so much to catch up on.
We're going to see a video now from Blue Rondo, and I think they're in the corner, so I'm going to slide over and talk to them. This is Masked Moods by Blue Rondo. Bye, Barry.
Bye-bye.
Thanks for coming along.
Okay. Here we go. That's Blue Rondo. Are you still a la Turk, or what?
A la Turk. No,
the Turk
no,
has left.
There's no Turk in there. He's gone.
Right. That was Masked Moods. I must admit, I like that a lot. I have to confess that your early things tended to go over my head, because would it be fair in saying they were just primarily dance things? I mean, what's this sort of renaissance in melody for you?
Well, we did one called Karaoke, just that nobody heard of it.
Mm.
We had one single which was predominantly melody orientated, but I guess you didn't hear it.
Sorry, I must have. This is Chris, and this is Christos. So, just if you have a colour telly, you won't get the two confused.
Yeah.
I think we did actually make a concerted effort and when we realised that people weren't just into dancing to approach songs with a melody, really. Because people, they don't tend to listen to them. But just, see, the original idea was not to have very melodic songs anyway. It wasn't an accident.
To keep it primarily rhythm.
Yeah. Well, that was the original idea of it. People just regarded us as having no talent.
Who was it came up with the original?
That's what I say to them.
That's what I say, they don't like it.
Yeah.
Who came up with the original Blue Rondo title?
Me, that was, I think.
Is you're the chap with all the... Because it's a Brubeck title.
Yeah, that's right, but it's also a jazz interpretation of a Mozart piano concerto.
That's right.
So I was interested in the idea of, you know, rebirth and the sort of, you know, revitalization.
Interesting, because I noticed that the Blue Rondo runs on a lot of this kind of bop imagery, doesn't it? This sort of 40s and 50s.
Well, it's a selection.
Great face.
It's a selection of things, really.
It's just at the time when we started the group, we just happened to be going through a phase. I mean, it's like people going through different phases of clothing, which don't really matter that much. It's just that people picked up on it. It only lasted about a year. We just happened to be in the limelight at that time, really.
I mean, it's a great phase. I mean, I'm very interested in that sort of period myself.
Yeah, we were until everyone else got interested in it. Then
drop it like a hot saxophone.
It's a shame, it's really.
Okay, they're giving me horrible windmilling signs again. So it's goodbye to Blue Rondo for a while, and it says Link 10 here. So, it's us, is that correct? It's us. Somebody say yes, is it us?
Yes.
Right, thank you, Spencer.
Wow.
Okay, well, it's the fabulous XTC brothers.
There they go, the marvellous XTCs. A big thank you for everybody who came along today to make this well worth doing. I've got to go, there's some hell of a lot of sweeping up to do. See you again, bye now.